Lumbar herniated disc. To understand what a herniated disc is and how it causes symptoms, it's helpful to first learn a little about the back and spine anatomy. The back is an intricate structure of bones, muscles, and other tissues that form the posterior part of the body's trunk, from the neck to the pelvis. At the center is the spinal column, which not only supports the upper body's weight but houses and protects the spinal cord. Stacked on top of one another are about 33 bones, the vertebrae, that form the spinal column. Also known as the spine, 5 lumbar vertebrae, labeled L1 to L5, known as the lower back. The sacrum is a large triangular bone situated at the base of the vertebral column and comprises of 5 fused vertebrae. Each of these bones contains a roundish hole that, when stacked in line with all the others, creates a channel that surrounds the spinal cord. Small nerves called nerve roots exit from the spinal cord through spaces between these vertebrae. The nerve roots to the lower back and legs extend many inches down the spinal column before exiting. This large bundle of nerve roots is referred to as the cauda equina, horse's tail. The spaces between the vertebrae are maintained by round pads of cartilage called intervertebral discs. They allow for flexibility in the lower back and act as shock absorbers throughout the spinal column as the body moves. They are made up of 2 components. Annulus fibrosus. This is the tough, flexible outer ring of the disc. Nucleus pulposus. This is the soft, jelly-like center of the disc. Together the muscles, tendons, and ligaments are called the soft tissues of the back. These soft tissues support the back and help hold it together. As I've already said, the discs that sit between the vertebrae have a tough outer shell and jelly-like center known as nucleus pulposus. The outer shell of the discs can sometimes break open, spilling the jelly material inside. This is what doctors call a herniated disc. Herniated discs can cause symptoms because the jelly material that spills out of them can irritate nearby nerves. Plus, the disc itself can bulge and press on nerves. A herniated disc is one of the most common causes of lower back pain, as well as leg pain or sciatica. It can occur anywhere along the spine, but most often occurs in the lower lumbar spine, especially between the 4th and 5th lumbar vertebrae and between the 5th lumbar vertebra and the 1st sacral vertebra. Symptoms. You can have a herniated disc without symptoms. You might not know you have it unless it shows up on a spinal image. Besides pain in your lower back, you'll typically feel pain in your buttocks, thigh, and calf. You might have pain in part of the foot as well. This pain may be made worse by movement, coughing, sneezing, or standing for long periods of time. It is often described as sharp or burning. People who have a herniated disc often have radiating numbness or tingling in the body part served by the affected nerves. Muscles served by the affected nerves tend to weaken. This can cause you to stumble, or affect your ability to lift or hold items. Loss of bladder or bowel control. This is extremely rare and may indicate a more serious problem called cauda equina syndrome, which requires emergent diagnosis and treatment. The diagnosis of cauda equina syndrome is made clinically by characteristic symptoms of saddle-like paresthesias combined with acute back and leg pain. Bladder dysfunction, which leads to overflow incontinence. Unilateral or bilateral sensory changes in legs. Unilateral or bilateral motor weakness in legs. Bowel dysfunction. And rarely sexual dysfunction, impotence in men. Causes. Disc herniation is most often the result of a gradual aging-related wear and tear called disc degeneration. As people age, the discs become less flexible and more prone to tearing or rupturing with even a minor strain. Rarely, a traumatic event such as a fall or a blow to the back is the cause. Risk factors. Although age is the most common risk factor, physical inactivity can cause weak back and abdominal muscles, which may not support the spine properly. Excess body weight causes extra stress on the discs in the lower back. Jobs that require heavy lifting, pulling, and pushing can also increase the risk of a herniated disc. Some people inherit a predisposition to developing a herniated disc. It's thought that smoking lessens the oxygen supply to discs, causing them to break down more quickly. Being seated for long periods combined with the vibration from the motor vehicle engine can put pressure on the spine. Using your back muscles instead of your legs to lift heavy objects can cause a herniated disc. Lifting with your legs, not your back, may protect your spine. Diagnosis. Your doctor will take a medical history and ask about your symptoms and what makes them better or worse and where they are felt. Then, during a physical exam, your doctor will see what movements make your symptoms worse and will test for muscle strength, decreased sensation, and reflexes. He might have you walk on your heels or toes to check the muscle strength in your lower leg. Straight leg raise test. This is a specialized test to predict if a disc herniation is present, especially in younger patients. During the test, you lie on your back and your doctor carefully lifts your affected leg to see if it aggravates your symptoms. Your knee stays straight. If you feel pain down your leg and below the knee, it is a strong indication that you have a herniated disc. In most cases of herniated disc, a physical exam and a medical history are all that's needed for a diagnosis. Your doctor will order an X-ray for lower back. Plain X-rays don't detect herniated discs, but they can rule out other causes of back pain, such as a tumor, fractures or other causes. There are tests that can check for a herniated disc, but most people do not need them. That's because many people who have symptoms of a herniated disc get better on their own, regardless of what that test shows. Imaging tests, such as an MRI or a CT scan, can show what the tissues inside the back look like. These tests can find a herniated disc if one is there. But we do not usually offer this test until a person has had symptoms for at least 4 to 6 weeks. In most cases, it does not make sense to order the test sooner, because the treatment for herniated disc during those first few weeks is the same no matter what an imaging test might show. I will discuss the treatment options later in a video titled Treatment of the Lumbar Disc Herniation,